Do you want to learn how to make overlays in iMovie? You know, those little graphics that pop up on the screen or text that moves across the screen? Well, that's what we're talking about today, and we are starting right now. Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Karin Carr, and I teach real estate agents how to get more business from their YouTube channel. But today, we're actually talking about how to make those graphics and animated text on your iMovie videos that seem like they're really complicated to do, but they're not. Maybe you want your logo to drop down from the top of the screen, like this. Or maybe you want some text to flash across the screen like this, that's a little more interesting than what you can get from the titles in iMovie. Well, let's hop on over to my computer and I'll show you how we do it because it's really not that hard. We're going to do it in Canva. So you're going to go over to Canva and start a new project, and the dimensions that you want will be 1920 by 1080p. So let's say that you want some text to pop up on your movie, but you don't really like the titles that iMovie gives you. You'll just come over here and you'll click on text. You can pick any one of these, and just for the sake of ease, I'm going to pick this one right here. You can resize it, you can change the color, you're obviously going to change the text to be whatever you want it to say. Then we're going to go back over to iMovie and take a screenshot of the frame so that we know exactly where that text needs to appear so that it's not right on top of your face. So you're going to do Shift-Command-4 until you get those little crosshairs, and then just drag it across and take a screenshot, go back over to Canva, and hit the Uploads button. You're going to upload that screenshot that you just took. Then you're going to drag it over onto your desktop, and I don't know why it doesn't come out the correct size. You're going to have to grab the little drag handles and make it the right size. Then hit position and go backward. Now your text will be in the foreground. You can resize it, you can move it, you can change the color of it if it doesn't show up well enough. I'm going to change it to white. Let's see how that looks. Just select all of the text, change it to a different color that might be more easy to see. And let's see if I make it this size, or do I want to move it somewhere else altogether? How about on this side? And the white still doesn't really show up. What if I make it hot pink, or I change it to a different color? So you're just going to mess around with it until you have it the way that you want it. You could also put an element behind it. You could make a rectangle or a circle, put it behind it, and that way your text will show up even easier. So once you have it exactly the way that you want it, you're going to click on this photo and delete it, because otherwise when we download this, it's got the photo in it. We're going to delete that. We're going to download it as a PNG. You want it to be transparent. So you are going to need the Canva for Work option, not the free version. I'm sorry. With the free version, they don't let you download it as a transparent background, which is what we need. So you're going to choose PNG and click that box that says transparent background. Then you're going to hit the download button. And after it's downloaded, you're going to go back over to iMovie and import it. So click on the name of your project. I like to import everything into the name of the project. Otherwise, it shows up here on the left in iMovie library. And then when you go to find something later, you can't find it. If you click the title of your project and import everything in here, it keeps everything organized. It's much easier to find. Now it does have a black background, that's because it's transparent, so don't let that throw you. You're going to drag it down on top of the timeline, right where you want it to go. So if you do nothing, that's what it'll look like. See how up above it says cutaway for our choice? If you leave it in cutaway, that's what it'll look like. You can grab this end, I don't know what to call it, the grab handle on the far right, drag it to the left or right to make it longer than 2 seconds, shorter than 2 seconds, whatever you want it to be. Or you can change it from cutaway to picture in picture. That will give you the grab handles to be able to resize it. So if you felt like it was still too small or maybe too big, you can resize it if you've chosen the picture in picture option. You can choose dissolve or zoom. And then when you go back and play it, you'll see how that changes it. So if we hit play, that's what it looks like if you choose zoom. If you decide you want to have it be dissolve, you just change it and then play it and see how that looks. And that's really all there is to it. If you want to do a graphic instead of text, it's the exact same process. So let's delete all of this text. And let's say you wanted to do like a smiley emoji. Just search in Canva for the image that you want. And I always look for the free ones because goodness, if I paid $1 every time I downloaded an image, I'd be spending $50 a month on graphics. So I just filter it to free only. Let's see, I'm not seeing any that I really like. How about a smiley emoji? Okay, let's say we want this one. We're going to do the same thing that we did before. We've got to get that screenshot from the video in here so that I know where to put this, because otherwise it might end up completely covering something that I don't want it to. So I could put it here on the side, or I could put it right in front of my face. Let's just say that that's where I want this thing to go. Then when you've got it, delete the background photo, hit transparent background, download as a PNG, back over to iMovie, and import what you just downloaded. Drag it down, put it where you want it to go. There we go. Ta-da! If you like how it looks, you're done. Or you can change the duration. Again, you can change the way it appears on the screen, but pretty much that's it. It's not very difficult.
If you would like to start getting business, and I don't mean leads, I mean actual clients, buyers and sellers who find you on YouTube and call you and say, we're ready to buy, we're ready to sell, and we've chosen you to assist us. If you'd like to get more of those, download the free cheat sheet that I have in the description box below. It's a checklist of everything that you need to do when you're uploading videos to YouTube that will help ensure people find them, watch them, get to know, like, and trust you, and then call you when they are ready to do business with you. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the next one. Oh, there's a guy outside with a hammer banging away because I'm recording. Of course. I don't know why I ever try to record when the kids are home from school. Cut!